myself Prasad, a doctoral research scholar at VIT University, Chennai, and also working as assistant professor, National Institute of Construction Management and Research at Hyderabad campus. Today I want to dwell upon the concept of lean readiness. We all know that construction industry, especially in India, still continues to be sort of struggling with inefficiencies like delays, cost overruns, wastages, and this trend has been continuing for quite a while now. India as a country has enormous infrastructure requirements. While we have severe shortages or constraints in the amount of funding available, and we cannot afford any more wastages of the resource from an overall sustainability point of view. Now, it has been also found that one of the recent advancements, that of lean construction philosophy, has been found to be very beneficial to organizations in improving the efficiencies and making a sustainable transformation. Now, this concept was developed back in the 1980s, late in 1990s, by Professor Laurie Koskela and Glenn Ballard, based on the Toyota production principles and the initial conceptual outlook given by Womack and Jones in their book, The Machine That Changed the World. Now, while we have found, while lean can be beneficial to organizations, not all organizations have been able to implement lean in a sustainable way. In fact, recent studies have found that while many organizations have attempted to implement lean, more than 95% of lean transformation efforts fail. Now, why does this happen? This primarily happens because lean by itself requires some intrinsic change in the practices, culture, mindset, and a working principles that lean advocates. Because of the foundation or basic groundwork not being ready, organizations which have attempted to implement lean just by simply focusing on the tools and technologies, rather than moving from a principles to a system-based approach, this is where the failures have happened. Many industries like healthcare, pharma, manufacturing organizations have done quite a bit of research studies to establish the lean readiness of an organization before implementation can happen. When we talk about construction industry, this kind of a comprehensive framework to assess the lean readiness of an organization doesn't exist. So what the present research work attempts to do is to develop a comprehensive lean readiness for the construction organizations, through which organizations can make an assessment of their practices, where they stand now, and what improvements are required to make a sustainable lean transformation. So the first objective of this research work is to find out what are the key factors, what are the KPIs in the respective areas for a construction organization to make a lean transformation. We have done reviews of the previous literature in other sectors like manufacturing, healthcare, pharma, and found out factors. Now, these factors cannot be applied as it is to construction organizations, because construction has a different project life cycle and different phases. We have improved upon the KPIs. This has been done through an initial list of factors identified in the literature and further through expert opinion. And the first objective that we are focusing now is to understand the criticality of these lean readiness factors. And to make an assessment of this, we have developed a questionnaire. Now, once the results of this questionnaire obtained, we'll then be able to develop the framework to make an assessment of the leanness of an organization. So what I'll discuss now will take you through the questionnaire which we have developed to make an assessment of the critical lean readiness factors for construction organizations. I hope you are able to see this questionnaire section. Now, the questionnaire basically introduces to the concept of lean, the lean readiness, what are the objectives of this research, which you have already briefed and discussed. So the first section is basically, capturing. So the first information that will be required is that of an email. So you'll key in the valid email address, whoever is the respondent. As we move further, the second section basically talks about the various personal details. So this section will capture on the name of the respondent, name of the organization where they are working, type of the organization. So we have captured various types of organization: owners, contractors, architectural, designer, consultants, academic institutions, and others. So job title or designation, the total years of work experience in the industry or academics. So this is basically about capturing the personal and organizational experience details. Next, the section 3 is basically the commencement of the lean readiness factors. So this is based on a Likert scale of 1 to 5. 1 is to a factor which, as per you or as per the respondent, has having the lowest impact on lean readiness, whereas 5 for a factor which has the highest impact. So the first list of factors basically organizational factors, which can be applicable to any organization irrespective of the organization, is construction. So what we have done is we have tailored these factors or modified these factors further from the literature review to suit the construction organization. So the first set of factor is top management and commitment and leadership. So for any organizational transformation, the top management commitment and leadership is something that is a paramount of importance. So this basically has 4 factors: the support from top management, organization's commitment to financial resources to make this lean transformation, senior management's efforts and focus in dedicating the time to this initiative, and leadership behaviors. So leading with humility. So these are the 4 factors. Next is of organizational culture. So this basically has about 9 different factors, basically on what are the organizational culture, how culture, basically systemic thinking, existence of cooperation, flexibility, blame-free culture, non-hierarchical culture, culture of seeking perfection. So about 9 different factors are there. Then employment, involvement and engagement. So these set of factors basically involves with the how organizations deals with the employees. So whether they provide training, whether they involve the employees in all of the organizational initiatives, how do they encourage employees to come out with the new initiatives? Do they take feedback from the employee? Do they take feedback on their commitments, on their job roles? Where are they failing? What improvement they need? So this basically explains about organizational culture. The 4th aspect is customer focus. So it lean, basically the one of the very important principles of lean is to provide value to the customer. So how this is captured in the organization, whether there is a practice or system in the organization. So there are about 5 different factors: selecting the set of right projects, existing of a process for understanding the customer requirement, customer involvement and engagement in the project processes, systems, periodic systems have to be there to capture the feedback of the customer from time to time, and how value is monitored and measured, whether there is a system or not. So this about customer focus and communication. So how does the senior management communicate with the employees? Is there a policy of sharing companies, vision, policies? How is the information, whether an employee has access to communicate to, from bottom to top, top levels and top to bottom level, top down and bottom up approach and horizontal, whether there are any silos or people can interact differently, independently, and how the failures are communicated. Next is basically set of processes, which is technology and organizational processes, learning from failures, which is basically benchmarking, how is an organization analyzing the improvement initiatives, performance systems, sharing the lessons learned. So this part basically comprises the first section of organizational factors for lean readiness. Now, what is most important component of this study, which is a contribution to existing literature, is that the existing factors need to be tailored to construction organizations. So toward this, we have developed construction project related factors based on the expert opinion. So the first is engineering and design process. So what are the qualities of the engineering design process? Whether there is any specialist designers, identification of requirements, involvement of the customer in the stakeholders in the design process, constraints in the design lifecycle, project planning. So this is the core of the one of the construction project, and research studies have suggested that project planning and production management process almost contribute to 70% of the entire project life cycle. So this basically delays with all of the project planning processes. How is the master schedule developed? How are the work packages defined? How are the constraints developed? How are the project resources scheduled? So this is basically about project planning process. And the project monitoring and control process basically deals with how the project is monitored, how the resources are monitored, how the constraints are addressed. Are there any systems for making an indication of where the project is moving? When are the master schedules revised? The next is a set of factors for inventory and wastage. How are you monitoring the wastages? Is there a rationalized planning of your store layouts? Is there any practice of monitoring the material wastages of various materials? The last set of factors are contract management processes. So Lean also advocates that we need to have collaborative contract management systems with all of our stakeholders. So how are we structuring these agreements? How are we taking their opinion? How are we incentivizing their performance? So these set of factors basically deals with the contract management process. So I would request all of you to participate in this survey, which would be immensely beneficial to the doctoral research to progress with my PhD. And I thank all the sort of respondents in advance for actively participating in survey. Hope this video helps in contributing this survey effectively. Thank you, all of you.